Hello everyone. Today we are going to talk about correlation. Correlation is a form of statistical method that helps the student to find relationship between two or more variables. It also helps the students and research people to do their researches, and when the researches are done in quantitative methods, then it helps to find the relationship in a quantitative variables. Correlation can be done through various correlational methods, but the two methods that we are going to talk today about are called as Pearson correlation method and Spearman's correlation method. Pearson product movement correlation method identifies the relationship between two or more variables, and it is denoted by a small r, whereas Spearman correlation method is represented by a Greek word rho. They both help us to find the relationship between two or more variables. When we are finding the relationships, they indicate basically in the form of 1. The correlationship is presented in the form of 1, whereby you have positive 1 to negative 1. The symbols positive and negative shows the direction or the relationship between two variables, whereas the values show the strength of relationship between the two variables. We have positive correlation and negative correlation. Positive correlation presents there is a positive relationship between both the variables. For example, if variable X is high, is found to be high in the research data, then variable Y will also be found to be high. Similarly, if variable X is low, even the variable Y will be low. That shows positive correlation, whereby in the negative correlation, the relationship is reverse. For example, if the score on variable X is high, then the relation with the variable Y will be low. Vice versa, if the scores on variable Y is high, the scores or the mean of variable X will be low. So, here we can find the direction of relationship in the form of using correlational methods. For example, when we are measuring the amount of intelligence or the level of increase in intelligence according to the age, if the result is found to be positive correlation, then age, higher the age, higher will be the intelligence. But if the results are found to be negative, then higher the age, lower the intelligence. So, once we find the relationship, it can only be up to positive 1 plus 1 or negative 1, that is minus 1. Now, we will see some of the properties that are pertinent to using correlational methods. As we can see from the slides, properties of correlation. Correlation requires that both variables be quantitative. That means they have to be numerical. We cannot calculate a correlation between age and smell because smell is a qualitative variable. Positive correlation or positive R indicates positive association between the variables, and negative R indicates negative association. A positive R indicates that above average values of X tend to be matched with above average values of Y, and below average values of X tend to be matched with below average values of Y. A negative R indicates that above average values of X tend to be matched with below average values of Y, and below average values of X tend to be matched with above average values of Y. The correlation coefficient R is always a number between minus 1 and plus 1. It cannot be below or above that. The correlation coefficient R is a pure number without units. R is not affected by the following factors. They are: interchanging the two variables, it makes no difference which variable is called X and which is called Y. Adding the same number to all the values of one variable. Multiplying all the values of one variable by the same positive number. Correlation measures association, but association does not necessarily show causation. Both variables may be influenced simultaneously by the third variable. They may show the relationship, but whether they are having any causal effect on each other or not, that is not determined by the correlation. Now, we come to Pearson's R test. It is the most often used form of coefficient of correlation, and it is denoted by small r. Again, it measures the relationship between two or more variables ranging between plus 1 and minus 1. Now, we will see the formula that is being used to apply Pearson coefficient correlation. As we can see from the slide, the formula for the deviation score for correlation coefficient is R is equal to sigma xy by root of sigma x square into sigma y square, where sigma x square is equal to the sum of x minus mx square, and mx means is the mean of x variable, and x is each individual score on x variable. Sigma y square is equal to the sum of y minus my square, where my is mean of y variable and y is each individual's score on y variable. And sigma xy is the sum of the products of the paired deviation of the scores. Now, to apply this formula into the real or practical data collection, we present you some examples. So, as we can see from the slide, following are the scores of the students on age and intelligence. We have to find out whether there exists any significant association between these scores or not. So, we have a sample of 5 students, their age, that is denoted by variable x, and the IQ, the intelligence quotient of the same students, 5 students, presented by variable y. Now, we find the total of age and divided by 5, so we get a mean of 48. And then we total sum up the IQ scores and divided by 5, and we get the mean of 52. Then, after getting the means, we get the x and y. X is derived from x minus mx, and that is how we are getting the scores of 2, 12, minus 8, minus 13 and 7. And y is derived from y minus my, that is 18, 13, 8, minus 22 and 17. Once we get the x and y, then we square them into x square and y square. Once we square them, then we have total of x square, and that square total is called as sigma x square, and the total of y square is called as sigma y square. Then we multiply x into y scores and we get a total of xy, that is called as sigma xy. So, here we have the procedure for calculation of R from deviation scores. Find out the deviation score x for x data, that is subtract mx from each individual score on x variable. Find out deviation score y for y data, that is subtract my from each individual score on y variable. Multiply each deviation score x by corresponding deviation score y and add all xy to get sigma xy. Square each x and add all x square to get sigma x square. Square each y and add all y square to get sigma y square. Multiply sigma x square with sigma y square. Take square root of step 6 and divide step 3 result by step 6. After following the procedure for calculation of R from deviation scores and tabulating it, we further then apply the scores into our Pearson formula, that is R is equal to sigma xy root of sigma x square into sigma y square, that is 295 root of 430 into 1330. We get the result of 295 root of 571900. That gives us 295756.24, and we get the correlation R value as 0.39. Then further, as we can see from the slide, calculation of R from the raw score can also be done by using the formula such as R is equal to n sigma xy minus sigma x into sigma y by root of n sigma x square minus sigma x square into n sigma y square minus sigma y square. So, we can directly tabulate the scores, raw scores into this formula and find out the correlation. The procedure for tabulating the scores and finding out the correlation from raw scores can be seen from the slide. Procedure for calculation of raw score: find sigma x and sigma x square, add all x square to get sigma x square, multiply sigma x square by n, subtract sigma x square from n sigma x square, find sigma y and sigma y square, add all y square to get sigma y square, multiply sigma y square by n, subtract sigma y square from n sigma y square, multiply step 4 results by step 8 results, take square root of step 9 result, multiply sigma x by sigma y, find sigma x y, multiply each individual score on x with that of y and add the results. Multiply step 12 result by n. Subtract step 11 result from step 13 result. Divide step 14 result by step 10 result. For the significance, check degree of freedom, that is denoted by df, is equal to n minus 2, because we are having here two variables. As we can see from the tabulated scores, 5 subjects, their age and their IQ has been given, and by using the formula to tabulate directly from the raw scores, we find the x square. Then we find the y square and multiply x with y. We are getting sigma x square, total of x square, sigma y square, total of y square and sigma xy, that is total of xy. Then further, as we can see from the slide, and incorporating the scores into the formula, we can see r is equal to n sigma xy minus sigma x into sigma y by root of n sigma x square minus sigma x square into n sigma y square minus sigma y square. So, now we incorporate the scores into the formula, such as 5 into 12775 minus 240 into 260 root of 5 into 11950 minus 2402 into 5 into 14850 minus 2602 63875 minus 62400 into root of 59750 minus 57600 into 74250 minus 67600 is equal to 1475 by root of 2150 into 6650. That gives us 1475 by root of 1429750. That again gives us 1475 3781.20, and the final result is again 0.39. So, we are getting basically the same result in the correlation from the raw score, and that again shows that the relationship between age and intelligence is at moderate level and is in the positive direction. That means, higher the age, higher the intelligence. After getting the correlation, now we can find whether it really is significant or not. To find the significant, we have to find the degree of freedom, which we can see from the slide. The degree of freedom is equal to n minus 2 is equal to 5 minus 2. 5 is the number of students, minus 2, we get 3. Consulting the R table with degree of freedom 3, for two tail test, we find that value R required for significance at the 0.05 level is 0.878, but our value is 0.39. Therefore, correlation coefficient is not significant. This means there is no relationship. Now, we cannot go just by the correlation value. We have to find the significance, and that only identifies whether it is significantly different or not. Now, we go to the next formula of rank order correlation. It finds out the relationship on the ordinal data, and it is represented by a symbol called as rho. This also finds the relationship from ranging from plus 1 to minus 1. And as we can see from the slide, the formula for the rank correlation coefficient is rho is equal to 1 minus 6 into sum of d2 and n into n2 minus 1. When we apply the formula into the data, we can see that we represented table. We here have again 5 subjects, their age, their IQ, and now we have to order the scores according to the rank. So, we will see the procedure here. We have to give ranks to values of variable x according to the age they have, from highest to lowest or lowest to highest. then give ranks to values of variable y, then subtract each rank on y from each paired rank on x, square the difference, add the square difference, and then we can use the formula as shown in the slide and incorporate the scores into that formula to find the correlation. As we can see from the slide, rho is equal to 1 minus 6 sum d2 into n, n2 minus 1, that is 1 minus 6 into 10 into 5 into 52 minus 1, which gives us 1 minus 605 into 25 minus 1. It further gives us 1 minus 60120 is equal to 1 minus 0.5, and the correlation that we find is 0.5. So, by using these correlational methods, we can use variables, combine them and see their effect on each other. But we always have to keep in mind that correlation only shows the relationship between two or more variables. It is not the only reason. There can be other variables or other intervening variables that can affect the relationship between the two variables. And this is how this two test help us to do our research analysis.